Good morning, students. Welcome to online classes. In today's class, we are going to discuss problems on present value techniques. Before going to discuss present value techniques, in the previous class, we studied the theoretical concept of what do you mean by present value techniques or what do you mean by discounting techniques and what are the methods of discounting techniques theoretically we studied. And today, we are going to discuss a detailed concept with problematic. So, let us start with problem number one. Suppose you have an opportunity to buy a debenture today and you will get back 1000 rupees after 1 year. What will be willing to pay for the debenture today if your time preference for money is 10% per annum? We can calculate present value of rupees 1000 to be received after 1 year at the 10% time preference rate has given below. So it means, dear students, after 1 year, we are going to receive 1000 rupees at the rate of 10%. It means after 1 year, we are going to receive 1000 rupees. Then today, how much we are going to receive? So we don't know that. What is present value? After 1 year, we are going to receive 1000 rupees. But how much we receive today? So that is we are going to calculating. So there is a formula for that calculation. PV is equal to future value divided by 1 plus R raised to N. So, PV means what? How much is the future value? Means after 1 year, how much we are going to receive? 1 is constant. I means what? Rate of interest. N means what? Number of years. Okay. So, let us start substituting the given information in the problem. In the problem, they are given future value is 1000 rupees given. The rate of interest is 10% is given. It is simplified. It will become 0.10%. And N is what? Number of years? 1 year. So, future value is 1000 rupees. 1 is constant plus 0.10 raised to 1. So then after simplification, directly 1 plus 0.10 raised to 1, then automatically 1.10. After that 1000 divided by 1.10, then we'll get 909 rupees. It means after today, if you are invested today 909 rupees, if you are invested today 909 rupees, after 1 year we are going to receive 1000 rupees. So this is a present value of future sum. So let us discuss one more problem. Mr. Ram is received 5000 after 5 years from now. If he invested today X amount, after 5 years he will be received 5000 rupees at the rate of 10%. Means we come to know that how much he has to be invested today. So that is very important. In this problem, they are given, this is the second problem. According to the second problem, if he invested X amount, then after 5 years, he is going to receive 5000 rupees. Then how much is invested today? That is we are going to calculating. Yes. So the given information is what? 5000 is future value and 5000 is future value and the rate of interest is 10%. And number of years is what? 5 years. So these three information given in the problem, just we are going to substituting the information in the formula. Okay. 5000 rupees future value. 1 is constant. The rate of interest 10 means what? It is 0.10 power of 5. 5 is what? Number of years. In the previous problem, they are taking 1 year. So in this problem, they are given. He is after 5 years. So number of years is how much in this problem? 5 years. So then 5000 divided by next. This is very important, dear student. So now I am going to explain this. Okay. Yes. Now I am going to show you how this is going to calculate, how it is to be calculated. Okay. The first we have to be take it. So this will come 1 plus 0.10. It will become 1.10. After that, we have to multiply 5 times. So this is 1.10. Okay, 1 minute. See, this is 1.10 into, wait a minute, it is not properly. Let's see, 1.10 into 1. This is first year. Next, this is first year equal sign. Just we are going to putting the equal sign after 5 years. First year, second, third, fourth, and fifth year. So no need to multiply putting the numbers 5 times. First year we want to multiply 1. After that, just remaining 4 times we are going to pressing the equal sign. It will equals to multiplication of 5 times. So how much we are going to getting? So we are going to getting after at the in the fifth year we are going to getting rate of interest is 1 plus 1.61051. So we are getting here. So this is what 1.61051. After that divided by 5000 divided by 1.61051, then we'll get it rupees 3104.60 rupees. If he invested today 3104.60 rupees, if he invested today, after 5 years he will be received 5000. So this is a method of calculation of present value. Okay, I think it is clear for you people. Okay, is it clear? So this is a method of we are going to calculating the present value. So no need to worry about it, just it is very simple to calculation. First we are going to make it, this is given in the problem, everything, future value, rate of interest, number of years, meaning how many years you are going to invest it, that is will be given in the problem. Future value divided by 1 is always constant, plus rate of interest. If it is given 5%, 0.5. if they are given 20%, 0.20, so like that. So then 1 plus 0.10, it will become 1.10. Just if this is, if they are given 5 years, then multiply into 5 years, we will get it this. Okay. I will give one more problem to you people. Next problem, I will give you homework. Just to go through that, you try to solve that problem. Even though if you are not getting, in the next class again, I will be working. So first we are going to discuss simple problems. After that, we are going to discussing series problems. Okay. Thank you. We'll meet in the next class with the different problems. Thank you.